Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, coming to you for the first time from the new house. So I just unpacked one of the standard bees. In fact, I've got all of them unpacked, except for the red machine. I haven't found it yet. It's still in a pile of boxes somewhere. And just wanted to do a quick acoustic recording. I'm going to be recording with a speaking tube on the old Edison standard bee on a black wax recording blade. Now, in a lot of the videos, I say, don't overlook the junk. Now, as you can see, this is a really nice black wax recording blade. But 15 minutes ago, it looked like this. This is a black wax Edison dictation cylinder that is just absolutely covered in mold, inside and out, just eaten alive with mold. But 10 minutes work, and this is what you get. A really nice original Edison black wax recording blank that makes fairly good recordings. This one has a bit of noise in it, but considering the condition it was in, that is understandable. And you can pick these things up cheap. In this case, I got these for $2 a piece. And I bought a box full of them. So, just going to do a quick acoustic recording. I've installed the Canophonic voice recorder, recording on the standard B. This is the old machine that I rebuilt and repainted. You can't tell it anymore, but it traveled well. I wrapped it up and didn't clean it, didn't do anything to it, just wrapped it up, and here it is. The very first recording on a wind-up acoustic phonograph in months. So I'm going to be recording with a speaking tube, just going to do a quick acoustic recording, and see what kind of recording we get on this black wax recording blank. Greetings and salutations, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, making an acoustic recording on the Edison Standard B cylinder phonograph. Recording with a speaking tube, recording on the Edison Standard B, recording on a black wax recording blank. About 10-15 minutes ago, this was a useless artifact. It was absolutely covered in mold, just eaten alive, and now it is a usable blank. As long as you have a way to shave these cylinders, you can save them. So just a quick acoustic recording from the new house. Just got the machines unpacked. In this case, just got this one unpacked yesterday. So just doing a quick acoustic recording on a spring-powered original Edison Standard B cylinder phonograph. So as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching. All right. Stop the phonograph, put our speaking tube down, remove the recorder, blow off the swarf, put it back in its box. Wow, lots of swarf. So I'm just going to blow this away. Install a Model C reproducer. And here is an acoustic recording on a standard B on an old black wax cylinder. Not perfect, but considering these blanks were $2 a piece, you really can't do better than that. They make good, bright, loud, crisp recordings. In this condition, they may have some noise, but this was the very first recording. So another 3 or 4 shaves and that noise very well may go away. It just depends on how deeply the mold goes into the wax. But these cylinders were just absolutely terrible condition. And as you heard for yourself, they make good, crisp, clean, loud recordings, and they are usually dirt cheap. So, as I always say, don't overlook the junk. But in this case, I just wanted to do a quick recording to test the Edison Standard B. As I said, I didn't even clean this one before I left. Made sure it was complete, wrapped it up in plastic, put it in a box full of peanuts, and shipped it. And here it is, in perfect running condition. So no damage to any of the machines that I have found so far. So again, just wanted to do a quick recording. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.